Tonight, FNMs. I've come to St Anne's tonight to ask you to vote for the FNM, to vote for two Huberts, one named Chipman and the next one named Papa. We had a good time down at Ignite Your Future for the young people the other night. Scores of young people gathered at the event as the torchbearers launched their new look and their new outreach program. Don't mind all those other people posters, you know. They have yet to elect to the House of Assembly one person from their young Liberals. We've elected six torchbearers. We even got a former young Liberal elected to the House on our ticket. That was David Wallace. They only believe in young people on those posters, not in real life. And so, young Bahamians, I want to say to you that we in the FNM are the party that delivers for you opportunities. And we will create an opportunity society to help you to make your dreams come true.
Papa's got a brand new man.
Now, last night I hear they had something they call Gold Rush. They really need to stop copycat and color edge, you know. Yeah. Nothing gold about them. They're yellow, yellow, mellow.
Color red, it's color red, it's color red, it's on the move.
I hear last night they had a song, they said it's called The City of Gold. We used to sing that at funeral times, you know. But wait, listen to this. That hymn includes lines like, there's a city of light, where there cometh no night. All my treasures are there, and its beauty I'll share. But I got another song for them I thought they might have sung instead of their song. You know it. It's also sung at funerals. It's called It's Finished.
No, sir.
Are you serious?
Dead serious.
Papa's got a brand new man. Papa's got a brand new man.
You know that? You know that one? That also got some lines I want to tell you. It says, there's a line that's been drawn through the ages. On the cross, a battle is raging. On one side march the forces of evil, all the demons and the devils of the hell. They were battlefields of their own making. Didn't know the war had been won. It is finished, baby. It is finished. It is all over.
Oh.
The only goal they're rushing for is the goal in the cookie jar.
Color red is on the move.
You get the gold for doing something, not for sitting on the sidelines, pouting about the stadium you didn't build. St. Anne's, I've come to ask you to keep the faith, to help lead the way for color red.
Color red is on the move. Color red, color, 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 color red is on the move.
You know, for me, the privilege of office, it's the privilege of serving the Bahamian people. It's a privilege for which I remain grateful. It's a privilege I never take for granted. But it's a privilege which others took for granted because they think that governing the Bahamas is their entitlement. They are more concerned about the power of their privileges than delivering for you. They're very desperate to get back to that cookie jar. They miss it very badly. I heard the leader of the opposition say early on that he already got his cabinet chosen. I also hear that Leslie Miller going around saying that he can be the next Minister of Works. And what a day that will be.
Colorado is on the move.
Yes, they are desperate to get back in. They're desperate. They are so desperate they're willing to close down the country, sowing seeds of unrest among some union leaders. One of their members even tried to stop Crazy Thompson, our MP for Pine Ridge, from speaking in the House. Perry Christie accepts and tolerates that kind of bad behavior. Over there, you know, nobody's in charge, and everybody in charge in yellow mellow. We know them. These are the same people who, during the debate on the BTC, had known criminals demonstrating with them. Remember they wanted to shut down the House of Assembly? Remember how they criticized the police for doing their job? They are not, I tell you, a group given to respecting law and order. St. Anne's and FNM's. Everything we do, the PL, we criticize. But I would rather get criticized for doing something than for not doing nothing. You know, if we listened to them, things would have been much worse in the Bahamas. Because we'd have done little or nothing, just like they did when they were in office. They complained that we increased the national debt of the Bahamas. But listen to this. They're in the House of Assembly. They were voted there by constituencies. Every loan, every borrowing undertaken by the FNM government from May of 2007 up to now, except for one. That was the Airport Gateway Project, a $40 million loan. Every other one, the PLP voted for. Everyone. The PLP and the DNA man never voted no yet. Now, the one they did vote against is the one that was bringing water to the eastern part of New Providence. That one they said no to. So if you live in the east, as you do, according to the PLP, you don't deserve the good water and the good quality water and the good water pressure that we're going to deliver for you. If for no other reason, vote against them. Vote no. You know, they also take no responsibility. I heard Christie, I didn't actually hear him, they tell me he said it. Because I don't waste my time listening to that stuff. I heard that he said that we take no responsibility for anything, and that we are not, that he is not responsible for the road. Let me tell you a couple of things. First of all, they tell the Bahamian people that the FNM brought foreigners here to build the road. Yeah? Now, how did we get the foreigners here? While they were in office, they went out to tender on two separate occasions, looking for foreigners to bid. Foreigners came, they picked up the papers, they looked, they drove around, and when it was time for the bid to come in, not one put a bid in on two separate occasions. For 5 years, the PLP couldn't get nobody to bid.
Are you serious?
Dead serious. And before they left office, they put the road out to bid. The bids came in weeks after we came to office. And a foreigner won the bid. Now they say, we give the job to foreigner.
Colorado is on the move.
They say, we give Bahama Hot Mix a company in which the Seminoles have an interest, not a majority interest, lots of jobs. Well, when I come to office, I met them giving Brent them jobs. You think he should be worse off when the FNM win than he was when the PLP was in? They won the bid. Bahama Hot Mix won the bid for the Howell Road. They couldn't get it. The PLP said, in order to get that, you got to do a deal with Bethel. Make him your partner. They gave him that job. They paid $7.7 million for it.
Are you serious?
Dead serious. Then on top of that, the little piece of road, It's 1/4 mile from the roundabout at Blue Hill Road to Robinson Road. 1/4 mile.
For true?
No bid. $3.3 million. Here you are, Bahama Hot Mix. Marsh Harbor Airport. Contract for $3 million. We add on to it $4 million, Bahama Hot Mix. How come Bahama Hot Mix so dead bad now? Because the FNM in? When they had the PLP partner, it was all right. Now they could go on their own. They could stand up like any Bahamian and say, I don't need no bike man to do business in the Bahamas. Need no partner. Who the only thing you gotta do is go pick up a check. Nothing else. I got a certificate. Get the check for me. Those days are gone. Finished with. The FNM here now. We deliver. You know, whatever we sought to do, they were against. Take a look at Nassau Harbor. Chock-a-block with cruise ships. The biggest ship in the world, turn around the basin right in front of the British Colonial Hotel and tying up at Prince George's Dock. Right now, we are having probably the best winter season in many, many years.
That's my papa.
Paradise Island, those are bursting at their seams. 98% occupancy. When we dredged the harbor, you know, they said that we're going to cause Sanders Beach to disappear. You remember that man called Fitzgerald?
Yeah.
He took the media down there. They had all kind of cameras rolling at Sanders Beach. So how bad it was going to be. Well, the cruise ship are coming. Sanders Beach ain't going nowhere. In fact, Sanders Beach is now a beauty spot. Enjoyed by thousands of Bahamians. Along with other improved open spaces, parks and beaches by your FNM government. And there's more to come. We are expanding Sanders Beach. They tell us that, you know, that they're going to have Urban Renewal 2.0. Well, we can deliver Urban Renewal 5.0.
Papa's got a brand new bag. Papa's got a brand new bag.
We are renewing and transforming the city of Nassau and the whole island of New Providence right before their eyes. They are embarrassed because they claim to love the poor, but it is us, the FNM, that are delivering better roads, sidewalks, and clean piped water with good water pressure to Bain Sound and Grant Sound and Angleston. It is us, the FNM, who are installing sidewalks along busy thoroughfares so the Bahamian students can walk more safely to and from school all over this island.
We've
launched new social intervention initiatives like Volunteer Bahamas, helping to restore the good neighborliness of yesteryear. In our next term, we're going to launch Summer Institute, help mentor and develop young boys going from primary school to junior high school. And the straw vendors, the hair braiders, the taxi drivers, and all those Bahamians who benefit from business coming out of these developments would have been seriously shortchanged had it not been for the FNM. And let me also say to taxi drivers, all of you taxi drivers and bus drivers who've been leasing place for $50 to $500 a month from all these people who sitting down collecting, when the FNM win, we will give you your plate. If I had my way, I'll give it to you now, but some of my fellas dead scared. They're scary, you say, we can make some other people upset. But be assured, God willing, when we win next time, we will deliver.
Are you serious, Papa?
How can Perry Christie look at that beautiful straw market they couldn't get built in 5 years and fix his mouth to say how the PLP put Bahamians first? They didn't put the straw vendors first. And most of them are their people. Most straw vendors are PLPs. I don't have any idea in my head that I can get the majority of store vendors. I do good because it's the right thing to do.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
Couldn't find nobody.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater than you.
Nobody greater
Not because you can get any votes, because if you're looking for votes there, you'll never get in. We do what we think is the right thing to do for the Bahamas and for Bahamians. You know, they're getting desperate. The full picture's shaping up before them. It's looking good for the country, but bad for them. Say it with me. What's good for the Bahamian people is bad for the PLP. What's good for the Bahamian people is bad for PLP. FNM St. Just yesterday, I was pleased to sign an order expanding the number of drugs or medications that you can get from the drug plan of national insurance for blockage of your arteries related to clinical depression, psychiatric diseases, prostate cancer, epilepsy, sickle cell anemia, thyroid disease, and they join arthritis and asthma and breast cancer, diabetes, high cholesterol, hypertension, and some 18,000 Bahamians are affected by these diseases. The FNM promised that if we won the election in 2007, we would put such a plan in place, and we delivered. The PLP promised you national health insurance. They didn't deliver, and it can't even come out their mouth nowadays. Last time, they were all around, oh, we feel so sorry for Bahamians. This time, mum's the word. If we didn't have the decisive leadership we got, and the will, the determination, the courage to do these things, the Great Recession would have been worse for the Bahamas. Anybody who believes that Perry Christie and the PLP would have done better in these times is living in a dream, in a world of unreality.
Papa's got a brand new band.
And as we've been told before, if you believe that, you've been bamboozled, hoodwinked, and lied to. It's a dream world in which the PLP lives, you know. Thank God for the Bahamas that we were in office when the Great Recession came. If they'd been in office, we'd be living through a nightmare. 5 years of them was a disaster. 10 years would have been a nightmare. Now, I know she will deny it. They are good at denying the truth. But when I visited an ailing Sir Clement Maynard, I vividly recall his daughter, Alison Maynard Gibson, saying to me, and I quote, "Prime Minister, I'm glad you are in charge in these tough times." But of course, that was in the days when she used to call me to complain about Obi Vilchcombe and Pleasant Bridgewater and that star. St. Ann's FNMs. In our next term in office, we're going to continue to focus on two principal priorities. We'll continue with our national security strategy of combating crime and drug trafficking and increasing border and immigration control and getting these poachers out of our waters. You know, but we didn't arrive at a state of crime in our country overnight. That took years. And it's going to take years to fully correct the situation. We understand that, and so do you. We've begun the important groundwork, though. Our strategy and our plan of response is in place. Implementation is underway. Let's ensure there's no break in the program this time. In order to do that, you've got to keep the PLP out. We all know the connection between drugs and guns that come from the high seas and flow onto our streets, fueling crime and violence. We've strengthened surveillance of our borders through an expanded defense force, presence around the country, in Grand Bahama, in Abaco, and Nicaragua, and now with a new base being constructed in Ragged Island. The new base in Ragged Island will serve as a forward position and center to better strike at illegal activities on our waters in the southern Bahamas. We have improved and increased equipment available to the Defense Force, increasing their fleet by 10 sea craft, adding 2 new aircraft to the air wing, and engaging just over 200 new Marine seamen. The Defense Force is badly let down by the PLP when they were last in office. See, some members of the Defense Force last time had bought into the PLP promises and stories about that fresh wind that was coming. Then during their 5 years in office, not a single new craft, except for a second-hand, unsuited aircraft for patrol, was purchased for the Defense Force. Nothing else. Every craft in the fleet of the Defense Force was either bought by Penland or Ingram, not a one by Christie. The Defense Force understands that now. They understand that other parties are a bunch of flammers. They promise big things, they deliver little or nothing. You know, soon we'll announce our new 5-year plan to equip the Defense Force so they are better able to carry out their duty to protect our borders from poachers, illegal immigrants, and illicit drug traffic. And soon the Defense Force will know that the FNM is the way to go. Our program of strengthening our police force has been comprehensive, involving the enactment of a new police act, appointing a new high command, acquiring two new mobile police centers, additional regular transportation, and crime-fighting equipment, and engagement of more than 400 new constables to walk the beat in neighborhoods. Now, next time in office, we're going to increase the number of constables. The number of constables, I say, Minister of National Security, by 400. The number of constables by 400 to walk the beat in Nassau. Not the number of billeted people, the number of constables to walk the streets to prevent crime.
Papa's got a brand new bag. Papa's got a brand new bag.
And we'll continue our efforts to reinstate a structured police organization while keeping the police on the beat in your neighborhoods. We've toughened up our bail laws, stiffened sentences for the serious offenders, and made it possible for the worst offenders upon conviction to remain in prison for the rest of their natural lives. We've now done the remand court up here in Fox Hill, and fewer of those buses will be moving up and down, creating traffic havoc in your neighborhood. Cutting crime is all encompassing. It includes legislative reform, legal and judicial enhancement, strengthening the hand of law enforcement agencies, and supporting and encouraging community involvement in fight crime. All of which we in the FNM are doing. St. Anne's and FNM's. Our other priority in the next term is recovery and growth agenda. That agenda is one of job and wealth creation. It's a strategy that will make more Bahamian shareholders as a part of a broader shareholding society. Our economic program will also be geared to boosting medium and small scale businesses. One of the country's most seasoned certified public accountants with over 30 years of experience in this field is your candidate for St. Anne's, Hubert Chipman. Chippy has worked with some of the most prestigious accounting firms in the world. He's the Bahamas country managing partner of Ernst & Young. You know, Chippy was one of those who demanded I come back to lead the FNM in 2005. He came to my office that day and he camped out. He wouldn't leave. So I told him, I said, Chippy, I know you're making plenty of money, but I need you to come in now. Just like you told me I had to come, you come too. And I'm glad Chippy come, because Chippy's going to be an important part of our team. He's joining the new generation of the FNM, the professionals, whether it's Heather Hunt and Marathon, or Cassius Stewart in Bamboo Town, Darren Cash and Carmichael, and Kieran Butler and 12 Points, Vincent Miller and Golden Gate, Chanel Ferguson and Fox Hill, Monique Gomez and South Beach, Michael Pintard and Cat Islands and Salvador and Rumkey, Norris Bain in Marco City, Peter Turn, West East Grand Bahama, and Capisha Parker in West Grand Bahama. He has a legacy of public service. I promise you, Chippy will make you a good MP and will be an important part of our delivery team. And he will deliver for you in St. Anne's. St. Anne's, Before I go further, let me give you a few updates on important quality of life projects here in Eastern New Providence. First of all, I deeply regret it took us so long to do that which we intended to do at Monarchy Beach. The Monarchy Foreshore Redevelopment Project, which began this past September, is nearing completion. It will soon be marked and stamped, delivered. The project includes both beach replenishment and the redevelopment of the parking lot at the eastern end of the park. The beach has been expanded and extended along the shoreline from Montague in the north to the concrete dock in the south. The upgrades to the foreshore include additional parking spaces, 14 trailer spaces, vending stall, and a boat ramp. We found the means by which we could accommodate the fish vendors the same way how we could accommodate the public. We are making good progress with significant improvements of the road intersection on Eastern Road at Fox Hill Road, here at Johnson Road and Newgate Road near Blair and Shirley Street. We are making good progress with significant improvements of the road intersection at Fox Hill, as I said, and it will continue best until it passes the entrance to Mount Vernon. The intersection improvement here at Johnson Road is almost completed. We expect it's going to improve traffic flow, benefiting all the people who live in the east, as well as the many parents who travel to drop off and pick up their children to and from school. The government recently acquired the land opposite the fish vendor stall at Montague. So in the construction of two roundabouts, one at the intersection of Shirley Street and Village Road, and the other at the intersection of Bay Street and Village Road, will bring improved order to the traffic flow, adding to the pleasant environment of the Montague area. Whether over the hill, in the city of Nassau, east, west, north, or south, your FNM is delivering for you. Now, come Easter Monday, color red has come from all over Nassau. On all these good roads, they have a family fun day that we are calling Red Splash.
Color red, color red, color red, color red. It's on the moon.
Red Splash is coming on Monday. We're coming to Montague Beach Park from Killarney to South Beach, Baintown, Grandstown to Fox Hill. Let's splash Nassau color red on Easter Monday.
Color red, color red, color red.
Now, just as we are restoring Sanders Beach and Montague Foreshore, and just as we delivered greater beach access and signage, we have a long-range program to renew and develop new beach parks throughout New Providence. One of them, for those of you who live in the east, is Yamacraw Beach, which we will upgrade in our next term. We'll also set up a car licensing center at Elizabeth Post Office, so those of you who live in the east won't have to drive far to license your car.
Yeah, your thought was finishing. Yeah, your thought was finishing.
And also ensure that you're able to pay your utility bills at the Elizabeth Estates Center. St. Anne's and FNMs. The country can't afford to go backwards to the reckless, do nothing, scandal ridden days of the weakest, most incompetent government in Bahamian history. Papa getting ready to reach for that bell.
Papa's got a brand new bell.
Little Brave got a toy bell around here like a little schoolboy ringing bell.
Are you serious?
There's only one bell and Papa got the bell.
Papa's got a brand new bell.
Register to vote if you haven't. Pick up your voter's card. Time, draw it now. I also want to encourage anyone who is persuaded to register to vote in a constituency in which they do not live to go and change their registration now. There's time for that. It's not too late. Don't be late in making things right for yourself. As I told you before, no politician can stand up next to you when the man say, are you guilty or not guilty? I also want to remind all and sundry, if you moved out of your constituency for 3 months or more, but less than 6 months, you may choose whether you vote in your old constituency or in your new constituency. But if you've been living outside the constituency for 6 months or more, you must change your registration to your new address. We don't want any carpetbaggers or planted voters in any constituency, regardless of your political affiliation. Whether you are FNM or PLP, we want you to do the right thing. We want a clean election.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
We are inviting the world to come and see and observe our election. We are confident that the FNM will be the government next time around. The people of the Bahamas are giving us every confidence that next time will be FNM time again. On Thursday night, we'll be in Marshall, Abaco. On Saturday night, we'll be in Grand Bahama. Next week, we'll make some other announcements. I make these announcements so the PLP can plan their rallies. They like to follow fashion, you know. They don't have a clue where they're going to be tomorrow, the next day, etc. They just heard it now. They say, oh, Hubert going here, let me go there. So the answer election come, vote for Hubert Shipman. Vote FNM. We have the better record. We have the better team. We have the better vision. We have the better leader. We have the better programs. Vote FNM. Thank you. Good night.